Well, now the election don't come soon, and the Center for the Coordination of Youth Activities, CCYA, well, all youth man and youth man no say, now we got the election, and as now we got the election, now we make sure say, we go vote peaceful one, and go back now peaceful one, now no put on pan, no violence, what do we say, no violence.
We say no violence inside this election.
In the run-up to the November 2012 multi-tier elections in Sierra Leone, the election management bodies and civil society groups interested in a non-violent and credible outcome of the process were faced with a lot of challenges. The challenges stem from the fact that this was the first time that the biometric process of registration was introduced in the country, and also because this was the first time four elections were taking place in one day. In addition, a significant number of registered voters were voting for the very first time. This required significant efforts by stakeholders to sensitize all voters on the electoral process. Greater effort was also required to ensure that first-time voters and the physically challenged participate fully in the electoral process. There were also considerable fears that the electioneering process may be marred by violence. These concerns were reinforced by the presence of thousands of unemployed youth who have historically been a source of violence spurred on by their political paymasters. In an effort to mitigate the impact of these challenges, the Center for Coordination of Youth Activities, CCYA, joined forces with ActionAid International Sierra Leone, UNESCO, Open Society Initiative for West Africa, OSIWA, the National Electoral Commission, NEC, the Sierra Leone Police, the National Youth Commission, and other partners to undertake a massive voter education and non-violent sensitization targeting first-time voters, youth, and physically challenged.
We are a youth NGO, with over 10 years' experience around youth development issues. And one of our strategic goals speaks to youth participation. For us, youth participation is a critical development tool that Sierra Leone needs, to empower young people in decision-making processes. Over the years, we have had support from different partners in promoting transformational youth leadership. And one of the things that we had done is to ensure that young people are trained to take part in elections issues.
Mr. Anthony Kouma is the National Youth Commissioner.
At no time in our history have we experienced so much effort at sensitizing young people against violence and knowing their rights, recognizing the rights of other people, that young people will have no excuse this time if they had gotten themselves into involvement into violence. But now they've proven everybody wrong, and I think we deserve to commend all the partners, CCYA, the National Youth Commission, all the other institutions, the electoral management bodies, because that's again, it was a critical issue in terms of how transparent the processes were. You know, those are sources of tension and conflict. And also the security forces, by not overreacting to situations where young people are involved, because young people are energetic and at times they have a wrong way of expressing their energies. But we think that they proved everybody wrong by behaving themselves on all sides, on all political parties, especially the two major political parties. I want to take this opportunity to congratulate the youth leadership of the political parties and the way, of course, you do not expect elections to be quiet, you know, there can be some, you know, fireworks, but it did not degenerate into anything serious that can threaten the peace. So I think because we've been tagging them that they are the source of conflict and violence, it is now incumbent upon us to congratulate them and tag them now our youth as people who are violent-free, who recognizes the dividends of peace, because if we have peace, development will come in irrespective of which government is there, and those who will benefit will be the young people. And it's evident from the statement, the address of the president to parliament. It was, I will call it, the youth address, the presidential youth address, because he committed himself to the youth. He made a pledge to the youth of this country, although he also called on the youth of this country, you know, to pledge in terms of their discipline, in terms of respect for law and order, in terms of tolerance, in terms of respect for diversity, and their commitment to the development of this country.
At a well-attended workshop held in Freetown, Ms. Miata French, the Western Area Commissioner of NEC, spoke to some of the issues.
Nobody wants to be associated with someone who does not have a bright future. At the age where you are now, you do not need someone who will be a drag on you. Anywhere you are, you should be looking for someone who will help you develop or show you something that will make you a better person. So let us be very careful. We should know that we have choices, and let us learn to exercise our choices on things that will affect us positively. We should not look forward to people to tell us what to do. As long as you have reached the age of 18, you should take responsibility for your choices.
The Inspector General of Police, Francis Munu, also raised concerns of security with the participants while admonishing them to remain law-abiding.
It is very important to avoid. When you avoid, you are on the safer side. If you take risk, you will stomp on your rights. If you take the laws into your hands, you have put your right at risk. So if you want to play safe, avoid crimes. If you want to take risk, you will risk your future, and you have a long way to go. And you have to invest in yourself. And how do you invest in yourself? One, by making sure you inculcate ideas that take you ahead, because the world is very competitive.
But what are some of the challenges facing first-time voters? In spite of these efforts, there remain challenges, especially for the disabled voters.
One thing that's difficult, mostly of them, the That's why ballot guide it was not available for the visually impaired, but usually call them the blind, the local friends. In 2007 election, there was the CDG, which was provided for the visually impaired. But this time around, not the National Electoral Commission said they will not be able to provide the CDG for the blind. This means from receiving the blind, they are those who are being manipulated by not giving them the access to vote for themselves after the Constitution of our own state. So we know that the party must come and receive from the people who are the first of all.
What are the lessons learned?
A lot of lessons learned. One, we learned that if we have collective, approach, a political approach to the issues, especially state institutions and organizations, civil society organizations, promoting, tolerance, equal rights, peace among everybody, that we are one country no matter what. We do not have red or green youth. We have Sierra Leonean youth, and this is what we are pushing forward now, that at the end of the day, what matters is the unity, the cohesiveness of the country that our young people should be promoting.
We have seen that once they are engaged, very well and extensively on issue-based elections related processes, they will become non-violent. They will take up responsibility of leading the processes. We had a lot of young people trained in the Institute of Electoral Administration and Civic Education. And they showed up as world elections world managers. They showed up as polling presiding officers. They showed up as electoral officials in different perspectives. We also saw them showing up as candidates. So we think that more capacity to young people will not just empower them, but will also start building a new political culture. So we really want to see that continue to happen, and we want to appreciate our series of donors, OCWA, UNESCO, Action Aid, and as well as partners, the National Electoral Commission, the National Youth Commission, the Political Party Registration Commission, and the political parties for actually opening up and supporting young people to participate in the electoral process.
Efforts like these played a significant role in ensuring that the elections passed off peacefully.
We have seen the turnout of young people in parliament, both male and female. We are having a lot of discussions with them in developing a youth caucus in parliament. We have also seen a lot of young people shown up in the councils, and we are developing mechanisms to have them relate with their peers in their communities as councillors and in their constituencies as parliamentarians. For us, this is the start of building a new political shift, a paradigm where we're bringing more young people, more energies into the not just the electoral process, but also around decision making, in the development of our country.
But in the views of the beneficiaries, these efforts must be strengthened and broadened to accommodate more youth in subsequent elections.
What we are advocating is from the planning process of the electoral process, the way the person should be involved. There are different organizations to work for a person with disability. We have this youth authority disability network, for which we do participation for the youth and with disability, the Italian disability issue, we have the flag Italian association of LeBlanc, the union for the PC. So all of these organizations should be called and brought in and doing the planning process. From there, to the implementation process, we believe that issue will definitely be taken care of. So if we are not in the planning process, definitely efforts on our problems, our issues, and the election issue will not be basic.
So my recommendation is that the government or the
the Lafayette Commission to involve more than 400,000 in the Lafayette process, and they should be well sensitized and put up to it because they come a large amount percentage of the population of the country. It's not the left out because this time around, more first-time voters came on board towards the Lafayette process than before. So the next election, I'm expecting to see, if not 50%, but a higher percentage more than this in the Lafayette process.
The education we give our political channels plays a very important role in towards maintaining the peace and continuity we are enjoying now. No doubt, should this voter education be increased by some percentage, by some every possibility that we have a more peaceful society than we have now.
Where then they can campaign, make you listen good. No make let them fool you, do your listen good. No grief for take the smoke, no grief for take the rum, no grief for take the vibes, no grief for take the lies. Make them show we how them plan for every native land, for make picking their land, for make youth man them walk. Me brother not to joke, me sister not to joke.
A message from the Center for the Coordination of Youth Activity, CCYA, where the Open Society Initiative for West Africa, OSIWA, Bato.